is a story from 1665. The time when pirates ruled the seven tides. And the man who would soon become the most feared pirate, and his ship still sails on. This story starts before that time began, when he was a humble, honest, hard-working man. With a wife, his one true love, on an island not mapped on any chart. Richard Forsyth was a calm, well-spoken man, always doing good whenever he could. Although he had behind him a tale so sad, one of sorrow, heartache and pain. When he was a young boy, just at the age of 10, his town was raided by sea-dwelling men. He lost both his parents to a pirate's plague, under the order of Captain Firebeard's command. Captain Firebeard is most feared on the sea, a ship made of bones and a heart dark as a night. Soulless eyes and a crew of damned men, Richard had to hide as his town was burned away. Richard and a few others had managed to survive, so come the next day they began to rebuild their lives. Through the years the town grew and grew, and at 22 Richard met his sweet Marie. Marie was the daughter of a new blacksmith in town. Growing Richard was a baker boy doing well. Their hearts met under the starry night sky, as the island celebrated another year passing by. The nightmare of his youth was washed with the waves. The turning of the tide gave him reason to smile. He and Marie were married in the spring, and oh what joy the wedding day did bring. These happy moments were sadly not to last, for from the horizon a ship crept to the shore, atop the island where the church did stand. The warning came, Firebeard had returned. The black winds of death had blown away once more, and the island could never match the pirate's force. There was precious little time to run or hide. The gangplank came down and all hell broke loose. Hundreds of pirates once again stormed the town, murdering those who would dare to stand the ground. Richard's wife Marie crossed the path and was struck down right in front of Richard's eyes. In a blind rage he went to defend her, but was knocked down out cold for the night. When he came to, the town was ablaze, his wife's body laid lifeless in the road. It was all a haze and his rage grew and grew. Richard couldn't take the pain deep in his heart. Let out a cry and he held his lost love, said softly, "Farewell, my angel bride." started taking its place at the top of the sky. Richard sets their revenge firmly in mind. He couldn't rest a day until he had sent Captain Firebeard to the locker of Davy Jones. As quick as he could, he sailed the boat out to sea, docked in the biggest town to see what he could see, get himself a crew and a bigger ship too, set sail for the open ocean and do what he had to do. The only trouble was Captain Firebeard's ship was very rarely seen aside from when it attacked. So Richard prepared to step across the line, loot and plunder until the time was right. He knew straight away that he couldn't get his way. He must learn his trade and master the blade. He must become what he hates to take it down, become the most feared man on the seven seas. Onward he went through the rolling tide, storming towns to ease the pain inside. The memory's still fresh of the attacks on his town, where he lost both his parents and a wife who was with child. Some years later in a port in Mexico, he heard of a lost treasure with the power of the gods. He already had all the gold he could hold. Now he was after something that gave him a little more. This sure was the greatest ever treasure, unknown who it was who had laid it to rest. It held a legend that those who dug it up would be placed in an undead voodoo fort. After many failed journeys, searching on and on, it seemed that this treasure would never be found. Until the day he came across the mermaid, who gladly showed Richard the way. Why the mermaids were so kind? Well, it's because Richard had fought on the side. They were being hunted purely for sport. Richard viewed mermaids as those of pure soul. The leader of the mermaids, Queen Gabrielle, led Richard to an island only found by the lords. Legend had it that the god of the sea only once a year would let the island be seen. Gabrielle had sympathy for the journey Richard was on, as her love King Daryl was taken in front of her eyes. And while she did know of the booty treasure, she feared using it herself would lose her, her soul. They reached the island on the waves of a rising moon, and she knew this was the tide on which they'd part. She gave him a kiss and softly said, "Sail to the ends of the world, let take me to the end." Richard wasn't sure what the whispered words meant, and he watched Gabrielle swim out of sight. The first time in years he had felt warm, but it wouldn't stop his mission of sending Bobby down. when she found her chest just casually resting in a cave. Inside it a bottle with a label that read, "Drink me and become the living dead." The fear of growing old was clutching to his mind. In no haste he drank what was inside. A flash of lightning and he was forever changed to the dark tide where his soul would be left to cry. Years of havoc caused by his hand, this once noble man was feared in every land. His ship painted red and black, with death in his trail. His soul unclaimable by a mere mortal's hand. However, he knew 5 years was no ordinary man. The sword of fire could take down the voodoo man. No fear and was still bent on revenge. Richard Forsythe was the walking dead man. His ship and the name of his sweet long-past love, he had labeled it Marie's Red Revenge. The power of voodoo taken from a treasure meant he could sail unseen in the open sea. In the world, despite all the claim, there was one still alive, the killer of his wife and his parents too, the man who had sent him down his fortune head. He had searched every inch of every sea, but yet by a beard was still sailing free. How had it been that he hadn't been found? Perhaps the mermaid's whisper meant more and said aloud. Remembering the words spoken by Gabrielle, Richard looked to the sky and shouted aloud, "Let take me to the edge." Gateway opened up and the tide took him in. Side. There was no land, but an edge was inside. Was this the end of the world? Water fell to nowhere and his compass didn't work. The moon shined on a ship at the edge of the world. The unmistakable vessel of the man who took his wife. Marie's Red Revenge sailed silently to its side. The two ships were floating side by side. Two fierce captains both chained to the tide. This was the place where two devils met. One made the other, but whose grave was the sea? Both crews quickly drew to the fight. Cannons were fired, they and swords took many lives. Both captains stood still, looking in another's eye. Anger was growing and the sea was splashing high. Onto the ship of fire, bid Richard did step. way that no one would forget. Frustrating and parrying went on for an endless time. Both crews were dying right there by the side. Blood was all around as the captain and the Jew, who would make the first mistake and perish tonight. Down as the ships rocked on the waves, Captain Firebeard slipped on the blood and the rain. In the blink of an eye, his heart was struck true. The walking dead man's blade it running through. This is for my wife, my dear sweet Marie, and for my parents, the life you took from me. Richard spoke those words as his sword struck true, right through Captain Firebeard's beating heart. When tomorrow's sun rises, you will be forgotten, said Richard as he removed his cat's blade. And in the moment of death, I looked in the eye of his killer and said, my soul is free tonight. Richard, many years ago, Firebeard was just another man from another town. He too took to the sea to ease the pain, made a deal with the gods, but Richard broke that chain. And as Firebeard shut his eyes for the final time, the mist began fading and the sun to rise. On the cloud did pop, the bright light shone and the ship was taken down. So quickly back to his ship Richard did go, to watch the body of his enemy be taken down below. He felt neither pride or a burden by what he'd done. He now had no quest but his ship must sail on. Firebeard and his ship, the Silent Reaper, now lay forever under the waves. They used to sail the black winds of death, now they belong to time and mythology. The walking dead man is now the devil of the sea. Nobody has the power to free him from his chains. Marie is long dead and an angel above. A devil may never receive an angel's touch. And they say to this day his ship still sails on, so far untaken and bound in a timeless hold. His heart is always aching, he carries so much pain. Watch out if you see Richard, for I'm sailing your way.